Morning, everybody. Thank you all for being here. My name is Will McDonald from Adelaide, South Australia, and I'm here to talk paintball collections, paintball stuff, paintball whatever, paintball content. Already in the chat, I see that I've got Dwayne from PBHQ, I got BB in, I got Connor, and I got my family back in the chat, and I've got Easy. Easy, it's been a while since I've seen you. I hope fatherhood is treating you well. Thank you guys for being here. I'm pretty stoked about today's show. I've kind of pared back some of the jerseys that I found for sale just to maybe put a little bit more focus on some content that people have shared with me this week. And I am pretty excited for you guys to see something here today. So let me just cut into a couple of things that I want to give a shout out to. First of all, Jared Cozier. Happy birthday, Jared. Jared was on our show, I don't know, 3 weeks ago, and I spotted yesterday that it was his birthday, so happy birthday, Jared. Now, just a quick mention of this. So I don't personally know this poster. His name is Marky Mayer, and he's a content creator, paintball YouTuber sort of a thing. And I've seen him pop in a couple of things that I've done and vice versa. And he's just put up this post. It's an original Mutant paintball jersey, Mutant paintball head wrap, and tank holder. All up for grabs to three lucky contestants. All you have to do is subscribe to him, and I'll try to get the link in the, you know, in the comments in the description below. And if you enter a comment contest on any video that you like and you like it, every time you do that, it's an entry to win that package. And I think there's three up for grabs, and the winners will be announced September 27th, 2020 during an Empire Mini GS review video. So get around that. You know, people work pretty hard to put content out there. Dwayne, business shirt. Yeah, well, I don't have a whole lot of dope t-shirts, so. Hey, it's Belle. I got Belle. Thank you for being here, Belle. Okay. Now, I realized the other day, I do tend to kind of whip through, you know, what's happening in podcast land. And I very rarely mention one of the most significant bits of content that you could be paying attention to. And that's what Matty Marshall's doing through Go Sports. And even though Go Sports is a sort of a pay-per-view thing, he does frequently, weekly, put out content on Facebook to check out. And this week they had Tim Cole, who's the head of NXL and seasoned paintball player. And I only listened to a little bit of it because I had to rush off to a work thing. But I did get, I did stick around long enough to hear some pretty important information. So currently, he says, quote, "We're positive about World Cup. We're approved to have the event. And it's a matter of what restrictions get lifted in the meantime. Obviously, World Cup's in Florida. They say they're using Disney as the barometer, and all the major theme parks are open." And then Matty pushed him a little bit more to just like offer a definitive soundbite. And he said, "We are going to have World Cup." So that'll be interesting to see what that looks like. I know they're talking about how they might split the day up, and depending on what division you play in, you'd get a certain badge and you can only come onto the grounds at a certain time, but we'll see. I know World Cup is sort of a major, it is the major aspect of the paintball year. At the same time, we are contending with some pretty messy stuff, so we'll see what happens. All right, and then, wrong computer. And then I'm a big fan of Play the Game podcast with Marcelo and Tyler. You'd know that. This week was really special because they had John Dresser on. Now, I've known who John Dresser is for the longest time, but I've known who he was because of his work on PB Nation. So PB Nation was obviously back before sort of Facebook and whatever. That was the home of paintball in the United States and really in the world. But I didn't realize that PB Nation for a while was actually the largest forum, bar none, above all. He's been playing for decades in all sorts of forums, stock class, tournament, high level, you know, pro competitions to 10 man. And he knows so much about this sport. It's really quite preposterous. And I've also known that he's a big collector of jerseys and other stuff. And he cautiously hinted, he seemed very unwanting to say this, but he cautiously hinted at having about 300 jerseys. So we might try to talk to him sometime soon. So that's a really cool episode. And so the other day, I think I was kind of like finishing that up. I was playing some games on the couch with my wife. We had the volume of the game down so that our son didn't hear what we were playing and want to come out and play. And so I just put on a podcast just to listen to while we were playing. And one ended, and the next one turned on. And it was same, play the game podcast, except we got Zach Hunter-Kazursky on. Yeah, almost flipped. So that was pretty cool. To have a local Aussie on play the game. So obviously Marcelo and Hunter are teammates. They both play with Crysis. They've known each other for a long time and they're friends. So in this, he talks about his start in paintball, the beginnings of STK, the beginnings of Crysis, wins and losses at the highest level, and how to develop a mindset to approach that and to achieve success. And they focus a lot on the importance of relationships in teams, whether it's a paintball team or otherwise. And they talk about Survivor, the fun and the fallout from some of his sound bites on Survivor. Let me see right here. I got 3-Pop in. Thanks for being here, 3-Pop. Oh no, BB, you gotta go. Okay, well, check in later because I'm showing something off that you might like. So that was a really entertaining episode. You should get around that, you know, if no other reason than Zach's, it's a bit of a legend, Aussie, local, so support that one. Now, of course, shameless plug, I forgot, I chucked this in there. I did do an interview with Zach 2017 at Super Sevens, and that is on my YouTube channel. You can check that out. Now, the Playing On podcast with Carl Malkowski hasn't had another episode since he had Chad Yaya Boucher on. But I mentioned last week that in that one, Carl seemed to be flirting with the idea, toiling with the idea of coming back to competitive play and whatever that might look like. And there seems to be a little bit of a signal of intent here. So he has officially thrown his hat in the ring to play with Team Smoke. And I think that's going to be a 10-man team. I'm not exactly sure. So it's not a... You know, he's not jumping full, you know, both feet back in. It's not a great time to jump back in anyway. But, he's itching and he seems to be coming back to the competition a bit. So that's exciting. Nearly through this, and then I want to show you some stuff. This week, Scotty Martin has released his newest episode of Down Under Paintball with Jason Bias. Jason's currently on a break from the sport to focus on some other stuff. But in this, which I haven't had a chance to listen to this one yet, he talks about his paintball journey, gives us an insight into what it's like to build a team that sticks together from the bottom to the top of the game. Jason's a pretty generous guy. He too has been on, I've interviewed him a little bit. This is the same era, 2017. I had a chat with him. This is part of this scene is part of a Super Sevens highlight reel. But then he and Adelaide were also on this show a little while ago showing off their jerseys, which was very generous of them. So check that out. Okay, so now I've got some new stuff that I've got in the Jason episode is great. Thanks, Connor. Thank you for getting around that one. And Brad saying great show. Sorry, 3-Pop saying it's a great show. 2.5 hours long, but worth it. I'm assuming you're talking about the Hunter one. I'll say those, the Play the Game podcasts, they are usually a couple of hours, but I usually listen to them while I'm driving around or doing my grocery shopping or what, so I find a way to get through it. So I've got some cool stuff that I've got in the mail this week, but I also have a couple of videos that I want to share with you. And I'm going to start with this one. So I had a bit of a chance to chat to Dan Woods of STK, and... What kind of notes did I write here? Yep, so in general, he just kind of talks about his foray into paintball. He talks about the establishment of STK and other points of pride along his career. And so it was a really good chat. It's so hard when I have these chats with people and then I have to cut them down into small bits. So this is part A. I'll have, it'll be sort of a two-part thing. Sit back, grab a cup of coffee or something, and hang in there for Dan Woods. All right. Dan Woods, thank you for joining me for a chat on the collection. How are you?
Oh, I'm good, thanks. Yeah, just hanging out in Perth, waiting for everything to open back up, I guess. But yep, good otherwise.
Yep, fingers crossed. Is that your normal office, or did you purposely set us up in front of all that hardware?
Well, my normal office is actually... in the middle of the house. So my wife and my kid would be walking around. So this is the paintball room. So
yeah, I do not have time to go through everything that you've got behind you. So fair warning.
It's just from a long time. It's not a reflection of my skill. It's just a long time. So I've kept a jersey, an SDK jersey from every year. So I've got 15 or so now. I know, just so I can kind of look at them and reflect back on significant things that happened that year in the series that we're playing, or it's kind of just like a reference point in my life, really. You kind of can think back to the year that everything that happened in that jersey. So yeah, I don't have a collection of other pro players' jerseys, mainly because at these events, just spend all that money there. The last thing I want to do is drop 150 or something on a pro player jersey. So all right. Well, this one's actually not an SDK jersey, but this is the first team I ever played for in 2005. So I played for a team called Venom. We had this sweet proto jersey.
Yeah.
This one I like because, so 2005, I just started playing, and in Perth there was this event called the Gravity Games.
Yeah.
So you may have heard of it. It's like just like an exhibition for all extreme sports, like there's motocross, BMX, skateboarding, and at the time paintball was in it. So it was amazing as a new player into the sport because it was down in I can't remember which showgrounds in Perth, but it was somewhere really really public, and we're playing paintball, and they're just like literally thousands of people just walking past having a look, and it was a real spectacle. It kind of also reminds me, in 2010, paintball was kind of really tied in with skate culture. I thought so anyway. So, it was just cool with all that stuff going on at that particular event, and paintball being cool at the time, like a skate outlet kind of thing. It was just a good time for paintball, I think. Really enticing a lot of new players.
Paintball is always cool, but. Yeah, and Scotty was talking about back in the day, he felt paintball had that sort of skate or die sort of feel.
Yeah, for sure. The next one I've got is the first SDK jersey. So this is the 2007 SDK jersey. So it's complete with little pistols on the.
Oh, nice!
just to be wicked.
Yeah.
And at the time, I don't know. I got this nickname. I don't know if it's reverse view, but it says porn star.
No, it's clearly clearly written.
Yeah, I don't know why I got that nickname. I've never been in a porno, but just at the time it was down the porn star man. So anytime I was down at the field in Perth, you just hear someone shout out, "Oh, you porn star," and that was it stuck for a couple of years. It took a while to get rid of.
I guess that's a compliment.
Yeah, who knows? I'm unsure.
But, so that's the very first SDK jersey then.
Yeah, yeah, that's the one. So we had Zach from Crisis playing on our team that year. And in WA at the time, there was probably 10 events just in WA alone at that point in time. So we had a really strong intro into having our own team. We gathered heaps of experience just playing in WA. And there was even, there was some some interstate events hosted in WA. So we didn't have to go far to play, good teams at the time, like the X-Fighters and Geelong Extreme was another big one at the time. It was a really lucky time to kind of get into it all.
Did you have any idea that, when you were first drafting those jerseys, like where SDK was going to end up?
No idea, I guess. It's all just kind of, been on the ride the whole time, I guess. Reflecting back now, it kind of seems a lot more significant than it did at the time when we started the team, I guess, because we've, made, 15-year-long friendships, and, it's just been such a, it's been half my life just with this team. So, I guess I had no idea that, I knew I was going to, paintball was going to have an impact on my life, but I guess, just this being on this team has also had such a, been such a big part. This is our 2009 SDK jersey. So I hadn't shaken Pornstar yet, so that was still on there.
Yep.
But this is the one we kind of started traveling as SDK. So we played the Super Sevens that year. it was an interesting year because the two teams that placed above us in the rankings, they kind of, well, for instance, at the Masters, we played Menace, and they had five American pros guesting on their seven-man team.
Yeah, I'm familiar with that era of time with Menace. I'm familiar.
So we were pretty pleased with that year. And actually, I got Player of the Year in that year. So that jersey kind of, significant to me for that reason as well, I guess. Then I've got, this is our 2011 jersey. This is when we were fully sponsored by Dye.
Dye, yep.
So we stuck with Dye for a good 6-7 years, I think. And they were really good to us for most of the time we're with them. I chose this jersey because this is the one where I think we really kind of found, came into our own. So we started playing in Asia in 2010. And at the time there were teams like this Iranian team called Dardis and Infernal from Thailand. They were kind of the top teams in the region. And I remember, in 2010 when we'd play them, we'd just be under so much pressure. We just weren't quite on that level yet. But in 2011, when we played them, it was more like, two big teams just going at it. It wasn't like we're grateful for every point. It was like, we can beat these guys. And that was actually the year we had our first pro win. So we beat Dardis in the finals in the Philippines. And that was good.
And by 2011, had you shaken your nickname?
Yes. So no, just Woods on this jersey. So
very good.
Yeah, finally, it was good. But I threw in because I watched Scotty's one, and he had this jersey as well. Actually, I played two events with SWAT in 2010 in this jersey. Then it became a conflict with SCK because they were going to play the same events in Asia.
Okay.
So I had to make a choice. So stuck with SDK. And then it was a long time before I got back on SWAT actually. But I've got some of their jerseys.
I was going to say, I'm sure we'll get to that, but what time did you start playing with SWAT again?
2017. So okay. That was 2010. I played the two events with them and I was stoked on that. And then, I tried for 2016, but the sponsorship with Dye kind of prohibited me from going over there. Right. So, I was in talks with them then, but then 2017 we'd moved to HK and it opened up again and got the call, so it was good. I got this one was our 2012 SDK jersey. This one is important to me because we played our first World Cup Asia championship game in this jersey. So this is World Cup Asia this time in 2012 was massive. So in Division One, there was like 30 or 40 teams just in Division One alone. So the event was, it was huge. Yeah. And, we came up against, Infernal in the final. They're really dominant at the time. And we had a real close final with them and, we'd only been in the league for a little bit then. And, to go kind of toe to toe with them, it was just exciting. It kind of, it felt like the trajectory for us at that point. We could only keep getting better, I think. Yes. The next jersey I've got is our 2013 SDK jersey. This one reminds me of when we won the Malaysia Open that year. And it was the biggest prize we'd ever won in paintball, still to this day. It was $6,000. So for paintball on this side of the world, that was exceptional, I guess. And covered our whole trip. It was just good to have a win, I guess. It's always good.
Pretty good feeling to have gone out there. All your hard work is rewarded and you're also not flat broke.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. You're not just, not just taking, you're like, oh, I've got the memories, you got something. Yeah. 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 No, that was good. And we're training hard for it. We're a team that practices every weekend kind of, without fail, especially at that point in time. So it felt like we were on the right course. Something about 2013 actually though was that could have taken us a different direction because in 2013 I said let's go play in Europe. but it just didn't kind of, it didn't work because, you know, we're all 23 or 4 at the time. So, you know, we're establishing our careers, I guess. And flights to Europe at that point in time was still over $2,000. Whereas when we went later on in our paintball careers, it was, you know, about $1,300 to get to Europe. So, I can't help but think, you know, if we went to Europe that whole time playing against the European teams instead of sticking out in Asia for another, you know, however many years we kept doing that for, I think if we had gone to Europe and had played Europe for that time, we maybe would have been able to achieve, you know, a higher level than other Australian teams, just you know, just by nature of the competition out there and getting that experience.
There it is, Dan Woods, taking some time to chat. Dan is such a, he's a soft-spoken guy, he's a very humble guy, but man, he's a legend. And those of you who, you know, perhaps from the States might not know him, he plays at the top level. You've heard he talks about playing in the Millennium Series in Asia and absolutely here in Australia. And he's a very humble guy, very giving guy. Easy, great chat. Yes, thank you. I love how Dan, he just kind of uses those jerseys to benchmark key defining moments in his career. And he illustrates, this means a lot to me. You know, sometimes when I talk to people and I say, hey, can you maybe show off some of your jerseys? We can talk about your jerseys. People often say, well, I only have my own jerseys. And I think Dan illustrates how your own jerseys are the best jerseys to have. So there's going to be more for Dan. I'll have more from Dan next week. But for now, so I want to show you guys a few things, and then I have what might be one of my favorite submissions yet. And you know, I've had Tyler Harmon gave me a submission. We had Brandon Unger last week. But what I've got coming up, it might be my favorite one so far. All right, cool. So let's talk about Yeti. So you probably know Lee Henderson, Yeti. I talk often about Connor Johnston, who's got PV Athlete that he's got up and running. And I think that he has a great potential to fill, you know, a gap in the market, and he's doing a great job of that. But there are other people that are also producing and kind of stepping into that realm. And Yeti is one of them. He's been doing it for a little while. Most recently, he's dropped, I think I have a couple of pictures to go along with this. Yeah. So he's recently dropped some joggers, but he calls them joggers with a soft J with a Y as in Yeti. I haven't got my hands on a pair of those, but he's got a little promo of people playing in them, and they look pretty tight. They look very sort of similar to the HK joggers. I'm sure they're high quality. I haven't got my hands on those, but he did do a run of masks, which, you know, it's kind of timely right now. In South Australia, we don't really need these, but in other parts of Australia and other parts of the world, they're kind of mandatory. So I thought it, I was curious, I'd order a few, and so I bought these from Yeti just to check it out, and I thought I'd share them on here. So my son seems to like the monkey face, but my personal favorite is what I just call 1980s Trapper Keeper. My wife refers to this one as the undies. So it's got that old school 80s look on it. It's got Grow Paintball on there. And so I don't know heaps about the ins and outs of masks and requirements or whatever, but I do know they're two layer, they're comfy, they're nice and tight. And they're made by a mate. So I was pretty psyched to get those. We don't need to wear these here, but I think they're pretty cool. And to be honest, I look forward to the day where we don't need to consider wearing masks. But at the same time, when I'm going to the shops or I'm just out and about, and maybe I don't want to be interacting with people, like virus aside, pandemic aside, sometimes it's nice to just put on your hat, put on your sunglasses, and not interact with the people around you that you may or may not know. And that could do it at another level, just increasing the anonymity. So these look like really nice quality. So Yeti's doing some good stuff, and I'm sure they're representative of the other work that he's doing with his joggers, etc. So that's cool. But what I'm super stoked to show off today is I finally got some Charm City products here. So Charm City, that's Mike Thompson. Yep, Mike Thompson. He's a one-man show producing really high-quality, like small-run paintball headbands. And I've always wanted one. I see them come and go. Like, they go up and they're gone. They just get bought up so quickly. But a little while ago, he announced a signature series run with Carl Markowski. And I messaged Carl and I got in on this as soon as I could. And I'm going to see if I can show you this. Come on now. There we go. So he's got that Markowski Charm City Collection symbol on there. Tiger stripe with these just defining red highlights. Now, I think BB's already gone from the chat, but BB, BB had some of this coming to him as well. And so it's super high quality. It's strong. The stitching is like spot on. Might not be as good as what Dwayne's mom is making these days, but yeah. So Charm City Paintball, you can find him on Facebook. He's on Instagram, and you know, this his work, it's not free, but man, it's the best I've seen. And they're all low, small runs, but essentially each one, like, I think there might be 10 that kind of look like this, but essentially each one is like a one of one thing. You know, he does them by hand. He's the one and only guy that does these, and I'm so psyched to finally have something from Charm City. Yeah, Connor, clean is right. I mean, it's just spot on. Highest quality I can see. So that's what I'm showing off for this week, and I'm pretty stoked about that. Now, I'm going to show you. I've been reaching out to some photographers, just trying to highlight the photographer's work and, you know, getting some photographers to share some of their jerseys, like and Trinity and Birchie and Mazzy. And I've been hustling Morgan Lane for a little while from Diamond Media and Design. So Morgan's been pretty quiet on the photography front for a little while. I think I've got a photo here from Morgs. She's been pretty quiet on the sort of paintball photography front for a little while, but you know, since I've been on the scene, she's had a really great reputation for great photos at the highest level of competition. She's just been kind of maybe stepping back away from it for a little bit, but I reached out to her a little while ago, and she and I were kind of chatting back and forth. And after a little while, she reached out to me. She's like, "Hey, I've got something. I just need to like edit it a little bit more." And I was like, "Oh, okay. Well, you don't have to edit it. Just send it to me and I can polish it up or whatever you need." But sure enough, just the other day, she came through, and I'm psyched to share this one with you. So this is Morgs' collection. So check this one out.
I'm Morgs from DMAD, and this is my jersey collection. I apologize, I have a lot, and I am much better on the other side of the camera than this one, so I apologize for how awkward this will be for everyone. So I got my first jersey back in 2010, when I first started dabbling in the paintball world. My team at the time was Paul Bears, so naturally that was my first choice. No name on the back with this one, just a blank. But this was the first of many, many jerseys to wind up in this house, much to my mother's dismay. But I will forever love it because it was the first one and it got me going. So next one I got was actually gifted to me, old school Raza jersey. This one was from Rob Sutterby, for those of you that were around back in those days. Name on the back and 92, so that was the number I thought I'd run with for a while. Didn't last very long. But yeah, this was the first jersey I kind of really got out and played with. Started everything, the downhill collection of jerseys, I'd say, from there. So this one, H2O, so old school, hard to overcome jersey, no name on the back of this one, but still love it anyway. We've got Frequency. This one was a Bam Bam special. Thank you, Bam Bam. Love this one. This was probably one of my favorite jerseys that they did. That nice, bright, colorful. It was good back in the day. I have Pink Purple SDK. This one's from Farron. He actually let me have a free pick of pretty much all of his jerseys. We settled on this one. Bit of a fan of the bright colors, as you may or may not be able to tell. Riff jersey. So this is from my boy Josh. Alright, that's his one. This is, I think, one of the first drum ones that came into my little world, so very much love this one. HK Rip Crew. This one was a gift from Mikey. Love this one. It's kind of what I really liked about this whole Australian paintball scene, is that once I started collecting one jersey, I just started collecting hundreds. Which was really cool. I kind of liked that camaraderie that came with it. I never really had a jersey to give back, but obviously I had the merch and stuff like that. But I loved, you know, I'd go to an event and suddenly I'd be coming home with all these jerseys. This one's from Dave. All right, this one, I really quite like this one actually. Red and black and a nice little fist on the back. I don't know why. It's a bit of fun. Benny Beretta gave me this one. Very nice purple and green. And we've got Sydney Swat. This one with my name on the back and my 92 coming back for a little bit of a play. Now, this one means a lot, so it's very special. This is one of two, I believe, from my girl Christy. All right, the Batman jersey. I love this. We'll never, ever, ever part with it. One of my absolute favorites, and was really honored to get given this one. It's very important to me. Vicious, I actually have two of these because I'm a big sporter. So this one's Shawno's, so I got his. And I also have Will Gunton's. So this one's made an appearance down in Melbourne before. I do quite like wearing this one when I'm on the field. Brings back nice memories. And of course, one of my prized possessions, the Envious. This one was Jakey Spencer. I think I actually have two of these in this pile somewhere, but Jakey gave me my first green. I was very, very excited. We all know that I'm a big fan, big supporter of the Envious boys, so I was very, very happy to receive that one. And then to add to that collection, I have a couple of the training jerseys as well. So I've got this one, just from Macca. All right, nice training jersey from him. And I've also got training jersey from Robber. So love my Envious boys, love those ones. We'll never part those either. I've also got a bit of a collection of shirts and stuff as well that I've gotten. So this one was actually given to me while I was over in World Cup Asia back in 2015. They put DMAD on the back and my little 15. So it's a nice little, you know, unicorn, angry unicorn. Love that one. Good times over there. And now I have quite a few of these, but these are my PB Impact, so all my Mazzy jerseys, which have my logos and names everywhere. So we've got the blue one, got the green, got the pinky purple, and the black. So I've got quite a few of those. I love those. I've also got this, one of my absolute prized possessions, my Impact singlet. Thank you, Dave Vasquez. He gifted me this one. I love it dearly. We'll never part with that one. Iron Man shirt from Keith DeVitt. So that was a nice little gift, that one. And then we've got my other Jake Spencer Envious jersey. Just because, you know, one is never enough. And yes, Jake, I promise I will frame them one day. I did say I would, and I will eventually. One day. SDK jersey from my wonderful Perth husband, Stevie. Love this one. I've worn this a couple times up in Queensland as well. Very comfortable. Just another favorite of mine along with Envious. Now, these ones I've bought. So these ones haven't been gifts. These ones have been, you know, teams that I want to support. So obviously I've got my Eskimo Brothers, and it's got my name on the back. So that was the HK version. And of course I had to get Eskimo Sisters as well. So, you know, we had to do that one too. Love what you guys do. Absolutely incredible bringing everyone together. We'll support until the end of time. Of course, my Marauders, all right? Love Marauders. These were one of the first people that started putting my logos on their jersey, which was awesome. Let's see on that. You know, seeing as I couldn't actually shoot them at events, it was really nice that they still supported me and family barbecues and all that kind of stuff. So I have a couple of renditions of the Marauders jersey, which I will treasure always. Some very, very wonderful good times with those people. And of course, this one as well. And then my Lucky Last, this is the latest jersey I have had added to my collection. This was actually a birthday present, which is now even that little bit more special, seeing as someone has now been promoted to pro status. So this is my DMG jersey from the man himself, Nazzy. Congratulations, very proud of you. That was a very nice surprise birthday present this year that came over from America. And yeah, that is my jersey collection. Thank you for joining me. Don't really know how to end this thing. I'm very awkward being on this side of the camera, but yeah, it took me a while to get this one done because I had to pull them all out of storage and I had a lot, so I apologize for taking my time. But yeah, some good memories in that pile, and hopefully one day in the future I'll add a couple more to it. So thank you. Let's go! Grace Buck. Alright, so I got that one to add to the Kennet.
Oh my, how good was that? I've been smiling for days since Morgs sent me that. Thank you, Morgs. I can't follow that. How can I follow that? That was just so good. I did want to just pause to quickly roll through some of these comments. Lots of love for you there, Morgs. And I want to specifically give a shout out to my buddy James Spoon, who I have spoken about a lot on this show, and he's in the chat, and that means a lot, and you're a legend. You guys are all legends. Thank you guys for all being here and chatting with me. I can't follow Morgs, so I'll see you guys next week.